everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The time for talk is over as we are just mere moments away from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Patriots going up against the Eagles.
Larry, this 2017 season has given us enough thrills to last a lifetime, and now only one game remains, and it's the one we've all been waiting for, as EA Sports is proud to welcome you to coverage of Super Bowl 52 from two-year-old U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. Alongside my good friend Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. We are honored to be here for the biggest spectacle in sports, the Super Bowl. Are you ready, partner?
I am more than ready, and I love the word you used, honored, because it is an honor to be here. It's a privilege to be here. My excitement is just about to burst through the booth. I can't wait to do this.
Well, and sitting with both of these teams and talking in the meetings and media day and all the hoopla that goes into this, there was one common theme. They're ready to stop the talking and start playing football.
Yeah, they were probably ready a while ago. Now they can just focus on it. It's done. The only talking they have to worry about now is post-game, and they hope that they'll be talking as the winning team.
And we'll see. You know, both sides come in with a game plan to start. We'll see how the adjustments are made throughout, because there are always adjustments in this game.
I want to see if they come out conservative, trying to minimize errors, or if they have enough confidence to attack early and try and take advantage of the other team's nervousness.
Well over 100 million people watching around the world. Welcome to you all. Super Bowl 52 underway from Minneapolis. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Time Patriot. It's LeGarrette Blount. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. 6 yards here to go for the offense on second down. They'll run again with Blount. And he works his way forward for a couple up past the 30. And quickly, let's check out the New England defense.
Malcolm Butler burst on the scene in Super Bowl 49 with his iconic interception of Russell Wilson to seal the deal for New England. What it underscored, his ability to understand what offenses are trying to do, put himself in the proper spot. That's something he's done throughout his career.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four. Foles. And this is going to be incomplete.
And that's a great opening series defensively. You force what should be a three and out on your opening possession.
And great coverage there on third down to force the incompletion to set up fourth. Here is the punter, Jones, as he gets this one away. This is taken at the 23. Him over, and he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. A tremendous return there, 39 yards. And the Patriots will have great starting position as they take over first and 10. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Hey, former fifth-round pick of the Eagles. This is Deion Lewis. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. And now we take a peek at the Patriot offense.
I think Deion Lewis has hit the NFL the exact right time for his running style. Not tall in stature, so he hides behind the offensive line a little bit. Jump cuts back there. Defenders can't find it.
And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. With a first touchdown of this Super Bowl and a long one at that. And the Pats have taken the early lead. And I'm sure for these guys, the break from the conference championship to the Super Bowl seems so long. To get out here and score that first touchdown has to take some tension out of the game.
Oh, I love the point you just made about the gap between. Think about the pressure that is built in the interim. To come out and get the first points in the Super Bowl, fantastic for the team.
Koski now out to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And on the first drive, 3 and out. I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of the game still, don't you? And Blount loses the football. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back, but it will be a loss on the play.
All I can say about this play is that someone's living right. I mean, he's trying to gain yardage, trying to get upfield. Ball comes free. What's that panic that we've talked about oftentimes that you feel when you lose the ball?
You can sense it.
Oh, you can sense it. And somehow he got to it and was able to recover it for his squad.
Holding offense.
Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
Again, here's Blount. And a strong running there gets this up over the 15-yard line. Give him 5 yards on the run there, but it'll leave him with a definite third and long on the horizon. And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because to me, when that happens, key guys are out, the next man steps up and plays well.
Now a hit and Foles loses the football, it's out. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And he will score. Touchdown, Patriots. And what we just saw, very, very rare. We only had 5 of those in the first 50 Super Bowls.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and we just saw it happen again. Extraordinary.
The defense has been good, and they were good again there. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. They'll begin here with Blount. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. Gonna look deep for Jeffrey. So they took a shot there on 3rd down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on 3rd down to bring up 4th. 46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the Patriots take over. You know, there's an interesting nugget that you unearthed as the Patriots come back out here on offense. The Pats, 22 starters in Super Bowl 51 against Atlanta, only half of those guys started against the Jags in the AFC Championship game.
They remake their roster better than anyone in the league. Because remember when they beat Seattle in the Super Bowl a few years ago? They come back two seasons later. Very few of those guys left on the roster come back and do it again. I think a big part of it is they know how to coach. They know how to teach. They know how to identify talent, bring in the right guys. And let's face it, it's the same head coach, the same owner, and maybe most importantly, same quarterback on all those teams.
Yeah, that helps. They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. Well, they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they've got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to, as you said, establish the run game, and they've been successful doing it.
17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. That's a matchup maybe they go back to their outer third of the field as this game continues.
Yeah, I think back to my high school coach, John Ford, used to say when we got big plays early in a game or good plays.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Going on first down is Brady. Going underneath for Lewis. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be a second down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best. And keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field. I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. So he got 3-of-1 tackle but couldn't do a whole lot else. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Brady to throw on 2nd down. Dumps it off to Lewis. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Deion Lewis, his 2nd touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Patriots add on to their lead. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to... cover, and you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Makes people miss, gets out, run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The drive starts with a handoff to Bell. And not a whole lot doing there as He'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Collision there as he winds up flat on his back right at the line of scrimmage.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. Here's Foles. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the prep.
LeGarrette Blount, and he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. That good for 22 and a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
And he gets it down to the 32. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. A reminder coming up at the intermission. We'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Now Foles, and they're going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
They'll start things on first down with Deion Lewis. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Wait, 20. Easy. Wait, 20.
On second down, here's Brady. He's going to air one out. That's caught at the 25. A gain of 39 that time.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there?
Yeah.
Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been...
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Deion Lewis with his third touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's 2 touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the book. Yeah.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. Typically down in the first half, I might say, oh, you at least need a field goal out of this drive, but they're down to the point where they need a touchdown, don't they?
Yeah, normally you know me. I mean, you've been around me for a while now, right?
Unfortunately.
I'm sorry about that. But normally I'm the one preaching patience.
Yeah.
You know, take your time, first half, you still got a chance. I think they're out of patience here. This has to be a drive that gets a touchdown. So if you're the play caller, you're going to that portion of the sheet that says big-time plays, specials, anything you can use to get yourself back into it.
And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. And that's incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. This is taken around the 12. Nice job on the return there. 16 yards. And that will come the offense as they take over. On first and 10, here's Brady. Now he'll escape to his left. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. As the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Now Brady throwing on second down. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Throwing is Brady on third down. This is White on the screen. The screen good for six, but it's not enough as it leads to a fourth down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
The final shot before half for Brady. Escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
And they extend their lead, a little added cushion into the lockers. What a way to finish.
Tremendous way. That's momentum that they carry in with them. Can they convert it and bring it back out?
So the halftime show of the Super Bowl abbreviated, ready to go for the second half. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So the Patriots coming out now. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some
All the way in. Touchdown, New England. Rob Gronkowski, 73 yards. And the Patriots are pouring it on.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone. This guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on. Just carving him up.
Four touchdown passes. Carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. And they're able to get the connection on the long touchdown pass. And that's one of the easiest drive summaries you'll ever see. One play, touchdown. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even been under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Well, when defensive coordinators game plan to put pressure on a quarterback, they often want to use blindside rushes, and that's exactly what they did there. The cornerback gets to him and drops him.
Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and they're going to be staring at a third and long here. Back to throw. Looking for Aguilar, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
So after the INT, it's Brady. Space to run past the 20. The throw left side complete to Hogan. A good pickup there of 22. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Deion Lewis with a record fourth Super Bowl touchdown tonight. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. They find some open field here. The 40, 30, past the 20. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
That was a special return, and it happened because he's a special returner. He has to have that approval.
And now it's blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a line. And now nothing but green ahead of him. He's at the 40, 20, 10, and he takes it all the way back. And this crowd can't believe what they're seeing. Things go wrong even after a touchdown in this one. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. Fielded about a yard deep. Shreds the tackle. Ooh, the juke. He's still fighting forward. And he'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. The last time out, another touchdown. I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you because this was just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats?
You admit Deion Lewis, the 20, 10, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Deion Lewis, 61 yards. And the Patriots continue to roll. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the numbers. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. And he will not be able to get away as Foles is taken down. James Harrison from his outside linebacker spot, forcing the sack for a loss of 8.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right.
Now a hit, and Foles loses the football. It's out, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return and a Patriot touchdown. And this defense has been extraordinary all season, and that might just be the cherry on top. What a play there on the fumble recovery touchdown.
Maybe it's time they get a nickname because they've played like the great defenses of the past. The Steel Curtain, Doomsday, the no-name defense. We might have to come up with one for these guys.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This fielded at the 2. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear them, the coaches from all the way up here. They were adamant, you've got to hold on to the football or else we have no hope.
Yeah, it's easy for me to laugh sitting up here, but you're exactly right. We were down there, that message would have been received a whole different way. Because turnovers, they've been a big problem for them. Got to take care of the football. Got to hold on to it. But you know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
And we just saw another example. These cornerbacks have played tight coverage all game long. Might start wanting to think about a few double, triple move routes to try and shake their guys.
You're right. They have had no room to breathe. And that is incomplete.
Had an open man that time. We ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Here's Donnie Jones now as he's on to punt for the 4th time tonight. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And he'll get credit for putting him inside the 20 as the fair catch is made right at about the 19-yard line. Here comes Tom Brady and the Patriot offense back onto the field. And nobody in the stadium feels better than he does right now. Just a slew of touchdown passes. He's been spectacular.
And you and I both know this is a team game, one of the best team games that's out there. But right now, I've forgotten what the scoreboard even says. Just watching what he's doing.
It's been fun.
That's been mesmerizing and a whole lot of fun to watch.
He's hoping to keep it going here in the 3rd quarter. And that last reception puts him over 150 yards now on the game, Charles.
And now it's not just execution. It's not just performance. It's a mental aspect that's going on. Because right now, he has kept the defense so much on their heels. Got them looking at each other. Who's going to cover this guy? And what kind of coverage can we put out there to try and slow him down?
The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
And he's going to be out of bounds down to the 25. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Ah, yes, Brady to Gronk. You think these two are in sync?
Without a doubt. And look, they both understand what they can do for each other. Gronk knows if he gets open, the ball's going to be there. And Tom Brady knows what a great security blanket.
And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Danny Amendola, 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Patriots are pouring it on. So he scrambled right but was able to look back toward the middle of the end zone to find the target.
As you know, in this game, sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules, because we all know most guys throwing the football are taught never throw back into the middle of the field on a scramble. He did it and got away with it for a touchdown.
Instinct sometimes, right? They just take over.
Instinct and vision. Sometimes you just see people who are open, you're able to get it to them.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it, because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, it's hard to get them started again occasionally.
And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. It's over the middle. And 15 yards there on the catch and run.
This game just keeps evolving and changing, doesn't it? You got a tight end who can move around a lot, not necessarily using a big body on him. Sometimes you take a corner, a better cover guy, and put him on him and try and take him out of the game, as we've seen in this one.
Okay, you're exactly right. They've taken him out of the game. That was just his first catch. Big reason they're losing right now. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
If he's their best threat on offense, use your number one cover guy on defense. It doesn't matter about size.
They have had him locked up. That just his first catch of the game. Big reason why they're down. He'll look to throw. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Can you believe it? It's a Super Bowl 49 hero, Malcolm Butler. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
Defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They'll start off with a give to Lewis, and he'll get this up to about the 40. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4. Second down following the run. They try again with Lewis. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run.
Deion Lewis, past the 20. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Deion Lewis, 58 yards. And the Patriots continue to roll. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Torrey Smith, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Back 22! Back 22!
Back to throw now on second and 10. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive. And it was third and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, it certainly feels like that kind of game, doesn't it? No matter what they do, it's going to work. That might be the absolute crusher right there, a punt return for a touchdown.
Feels like there's been a lot of crushers in this game. This lead just gets bigger. Extra point try for Gostkowski. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And out now come the Eagles. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweat.
Now a hit, and Foles loses the football. It's out.
Plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
They'll run it now out of the gun. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll force upon him a third and 14.
Well, it looks like they caught him off guard on second and very long by running the football. All right, we always talk about tendency breakers and counters and doing things opposite the grain, and that worked very well for him. Picked up really nice yardage, but they still have a lot of work to do on third down.
And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, they're slinging it, and then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. Here's Donnie Jones now, as he'll come on to kick for a sixth time tonight. And the fair catch is made at about the 27-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. They start the drive on the ground with Lewis. And now running right through him. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football, getting away from one and trying to turn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
Again, it's Lewis. Skirts by him at the 35. Oh, a and now he bowls him over. And again the foot. Deion Lewis, 20. And all the way down to the 10-yard line. A big play there for New England. And even 60 yards on the ground. One of the reasons that this team is on this win streak, big runs like that.
When you see runs like that broken off, you know this is a team that's confident running the football. A big reason why this streak is occurring.
And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it. But he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line.
I know we could sit up here and dance around it a little bit. But going for two in this situation, somebody doesn't like someone else. There is no doubt in my mind.
Well, what they couldn't see is you lean back in your chair and you went,
I mean,
that's not a good decision. They didn't get it, though.
Yeah, I don't think you can just say, well, my kicker's hurt in this spot.
No,
okay. And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And he lost the football, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
All right, you've had to put up with me in this booth. I'm going to try and be simple this time and succinct. It simply has not been their night.
No, I think that fumble's kind of indicative of how this whole evening's gone, isn't it?
Without a doubt. I mean, they've tried, but nothing has ever really taken throughout the game. That's why they're down so big.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Brady gonna throw here. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. And barring something unforeseen, this will be the last play of the game. Brady gives this one to Lewis. Got some real estate inside the 30. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play, so it doesn't affect the outcome. But a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lagniappe, a little extra on top. One of the fun parts about working with you is that we've learned that there are different ways to do things than the way we were brought up to do them. This is mad. Of course they were going to go ahead and get another score. What do you mean take a knee?
And that just makes the final margin even more lopsided. I heard they earned themselves a cold drink from the fridge, right?
There's no
Maybe
doubt about it.
Maybe some pretzels, too, some hummus. Go crazy.
See, we've learned.
Go crazy.
We have learned the Madden way of doing things.
And it's another Super Bowl title for the New England Patriots. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. It actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
Super Bowl champs, a Lombardi trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.